Employers must ensure that workers are protected from the harsh and sometimes life-threatening effects of chemical exposure. As we have discussed in this video series, it is important to understand what chemicals are present in the workplace, how they are used, and the related exposure risk, so appropriate measures can be taken to protect the health and safety of everyone in your facility. Once you have recognized and assessed the hazardous substances in your workplace, you can control the hazard. There are three main locations where you can put controls for a hazard: at the source, along the path, and at the worker. Controls at the source are always preferred. The best approach is to follow this hierarchy of controls. At the source, eliminate the hazardous chemical if possible. Consider whether the process can be changed so the chemical is not required. If not, substitute with a less hazardous chemical. For example, a chemical that comes in a pellet form gives off less inhalable dust than a powdered form. Install engineering controls, such as ventilation and dust capture systems, to remove the contaminant and prevent exposure. Along the path, develop and implement safe work practices and procedures to manage instances when a hazard cannot be isolated or eliminated. For example, using a screen to protect workers from welding flash and sparks, proper grounding and bonding procedures when dispensing flammable substances, and using non-sparking tools to open flammable liquid drums. Implement administrative controls to further contain the risk. These could include rotating employees to minimize exposure and scheduling high-risk activities when fewer workers are present. Develop and implement an education and training program to ensure employees understand what chemical hazards are in the workplace and what controls are in place to protect their health and safety. At the worker, use personal protective equipment. As with any hazard, the use of personal protective equipment, or PPE, is the last line of defense. It is best used in combination with the other existing controls. However, in the case of an emergency, PPE may be the best control available. PPE can include goggles and face shields, boots, gloves, aprons, and respiratory protection like half face mask, full face piece respirators, or helmet hoods. It is preferable that everyone have their own equipment, be fit tested to ensure it's suitable for the individual, and be trained on how to use it effectively. Chemicals are everywhere, even in the smallest of workplaces with relatively simple processes. Remember to always read product labels, refer to safety data sheets, and follow safe handling procedures as outlined by the supplier. By doing so, you'll go a long way to keeping your workers healthy and safe. I'm Ilma Benu, and this has been your health and safety tip from Workplace Safety and Prevention Services. For more information, visit wsps.ca.